And Senator Bernie Sanders announced new funding today for programs that help young people turn their lives around. The U.S. leads the world in the number of its citizens in jail, and Sanders says delinquency prevention efforts here in this country are grossly underfunded. Here's News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter.
He's just 17, but James Porter knows what it's like to hit a dead end.
Before, you know, I drank, partied, got in a lot of trouble, a lot of fighting at the house.
Even time behind bars.
This one's four feet.
But now he's spending his days in Youth Build, a Burlington area program teaching young people who've dropped out of school.
This program's keeping me out of jail.
Teaching them new skills in construction and home weatherization. And over the course of 10 months, it is also coaxing many of them back toward their high school diploma.
I am very proud to announce.
It is one of four different organizations winning new federal funding to help at-risk young people across Vermont.
And we have to give them an opportunity to use their intelligence and their energy in a constructive way.
For Youth Build, it means expansion into central Vermont, where they'll enroll up to 8 kids at a time in a program just like this.
I have good opportunities after I graduate and good skills to learn for the careers out in the world.
Johnny wants to go first to college. Matt wants to work for a local contractor. All feel productive, in some cases for the first time.
I could make money out of this. I could get my own house, you know, everything. Like, I could have a good life, and this is where it's starting.
In Burlington, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.
Other grant winners include Youth in Transition, that's for teens in Lamoille and Anniseg counties, Rosie's Girls, that's a camp for middle school age girls, and Learning Together, a program for very young parents in counties all across Vermont.